Welcome to today's Web Extra. We're talking with Steve Jagler. He's the executive editor of BizTimes Milwaukee, a leading business publication in this part of the state. And we have been talking about a piece that's coming out in your magazine that talks about the recovery, that we are now seeing concrete signs of recovery. In the interview on the TV show, Steve, we talked about better home sales, better auto sales, improvement in retail sales. But you go through about 10 different signs. Tell us some of the other things you're seeing out there.
Yeah, our reporters kind of fanned out in different directions and to touch different, account for different parts of the economy. And we just found so many bright signs of hope for the economy, so many indications that things are moving the right direction. Temporary hiring is up. Factory orders are up, according to the Institute of Supply Management. Trucking, Schneider National in Green Bay is hiring 2,500 more truck drivers because as the economy turns around and all of these goods are being produced again, they need trucks and truck drivers to transport them.
Move the cargo.
You got to move the merchandise.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And you look at the airport, Mitchell International had a record month of February, so people are traveling again. Automobile sales are skyrocketing relative to where they were a year ago, 44% up. We accounted for that in the TV program, but Ford's production's up 43%, GM is up 11.5% from a year ago. We looked at our BizTimes stock index, which tracks the cumulative value of publicly held companies based in southeastern Wisconsin, and that's up 13% from January.
That's something that deals with the whole notion of personal wealth. When people can look at their 401ks or look at the money they have invested in the stock market, they just feel better about things. They can see signs of
Absolutely.
Improvement.
Absolutely. You know, you see it in your quarterly 401k statement, whatever. The Dow recently got back up to the 1,100 mark or 11,000 mark, and we talked to one economic forecaster who foresees it getting up over 12,000 in the very near future. That's another bright sign.
Let's talk about unemployment, which we did deal with to some extent on the TV show, but that's the one thing here that's lagging, and I guess we can expect it based on the economists you hear from, based on what the Federal Reserve Chairman is saying. We're still talking about a little bit of time before we see that unemployment number really change a great deal, aren't we?
It is. It hangs over us. It casts this pall, this shadow over us. There's no doubt about it. And until we see that number, markedly moving in the right direction, I think there will always be a sense of hesitation in our collective psyche. But that was one reason we wanted to do this report, was we kept seeing all of these other positive factors from all these other businesses and industries that are moving the right direction that we believe are going to add momentum. And at some point, we're going to reach a tipping point where that unemployment number is going to, we're going to chip into that.
I think it's kind of interesting where you get ideas for stories. When you first wrote about the Great Recession and the signs you saw in your own neighborhood that made you go, this is not just a typical downturn. This is something more serious. The idea for this story came in part from an event you attended here in Milwaukee where you saw a bunch of public relations people there.
Yes, the city birthday party, and which I'm involved with through the Milwaukee Press Club. And so the place was just teeming with public relations people. I mean that in a good way to the you public relations people. Some of you are my best friends. But the place was just crawling with them. They were everywhere. And, when I talked to these people a year ago, I would ask them how things were going at their companies, and invariably the response would be, we had to lay off three more people. Business is so slow. Nobody's returning our phone calls. They're the canaries in the coal mine in a lot of ways when a recession hits because companies, that's one of the places that companies first cut back is on promoting themselves and public relations and advertising. So when the economy turns around like it has, the PR people are among the first to see a bounce back to their businesses. And at the city birthday party, every PR professional that I spoke to, it was unanimous across the board. They were just giddy with how much more business they were having this year relative to last year, that people were returning their phone calls, and that companies again, finally had new products and services that they needed the public to know about, and they wanted to get the word out about, so that they were happy. And that was really got me thinking, you know, maybe things are turning around here, and that kind of put this story into motion.
And the magazine comes out on the 16th?
April 16th.
April 16th. You know, we'll have to add that public relations thing to the list of leading economic indicators. A little known
indicator. Hard to quantify. But
exactly. Steve Jagler, the executive editor from BizTimes Milwaukee. It's good to have you with us. Thanks for joining us for today's Web Extra.
Thank you, Mike. Appreciate it.